Rolling down streets paved with desire, broken dreams line shattered landscapes, public domain reoccurring refrain belongs to no one.
Exploits of the incredible Rubber Boys, Steve Size, Eric Sanderson, Ray Barbie, and Chet Thomas.
Hey. Debutantes, petite sophistication, indelible elegance.
my whole life was basically geared around skateboarding. Me and my partner Joe Meyer had one of the first indoor skateboard parks. It's got the mini chin ramp that Lance built, and it's got the expo ramp and the expo contest and some street stuff and some smaller half pipes, but all indoors in Vancouver, and it's been a lot of fun. I opened about a year and a half now.
I definitely think that there's a place for girl skaters. I think that it's not because we're females that we can't skate. We just skate differently. Skating is the funnest thing I've ever done. I want to skate till I'm old and gray and my bones will break and they won't heal anymore, so I can't skate. I encourage girls to skate, sure. Anybody who wants to skate, just skate.
Hey, you wanna buy a, what is this thing? Chinese.
Oh, we went there.
Hey, one of those, hey, give me one of those.
I might not have much dinero, but I know where to go. I hop up on my board skate and take off like a bat. Straight out of hell for the home of the burritos that are big and fat.
Hey, take me back to La Cumbre, I want another steak burrito. A nice size cold Corona and a cider of carnitas. Take me back to La Cumbre, I want another steak burrito. A nice size cold Corona and a cider of carnitas.
Benito, Benito on the wall when I knew she was the one for me. I went home and I dreamt of her as she got down on her knee. She held a bugle in her left hand and a Mexican flag in the right. A bullet belt wrapped across her chest and you know it's like well that night.
Hey, take me back to the cumbre, I want another steak burrito. A nice size cold Corona and a side order of carnitas. Take me back to the cumbre, I want another steak burrito. A nice size cold Corona and a side order of carnitas.
I grew up in Los Angeles and I ate lots of Mexican food. Once in a while it tasted funky, but most of the time it tasted good. My life changed almost overnight as I got off of the bus. At 16th and Valencia, where I found the taqueria for us. You would not know for looking, this place will be the one. With my first bite, it was over for sight until my burrito was done. I sat back and I wondered whether I could eat some more. Then I looked up the menu and thought about what I could score. I ordered up a taco with a little rice and beans. One or two quesadillas and a chili verde, that was me. A couple more Coronas to help it all go down. By the time I finished, I was passed out on the ground.
Get more verboten here.
Balls in the back, please.
She's right, Governor.
wipe out all over the place, baby. And knees slide out.
Vance was pretty flabbergasted, I think that's the word. Because somebody had told him that, yeah, you know, Mike's doing 540s, you know, and he's like, oh, yeah. I've been skating about 11 and a half years now. I don't think that skate parks, you know, will be the future, you know, but it's a way of showing people, hey, they can build ramps in their yard, they can find, you know, places to build ramps.
It's a good place for the kids to be, and they don't have to be in the street anymore.
My life is skateboarding, yeah, I guess it pretty much is. I mean, I wake up and breakfast and go to the skate park and skate. I like skating in my own park because I can do what I want, you know. I tell the guys, you know, I'm gonna go, and you know, nobody snakes me because they don't want to get kicked out. There's just so many possibilities with the mini ramps. You can just work them every which way.
Hey! There's nothing that's so creative that I can just go out on my own, like in the barn or something, or any place, and just let go. Like now, I study and stuff, and you get so intense. People think it's all good that I make great, my grades are good and all that, and skate and all that at the same time, but it's not true. I mean, you can't do one without the other. If I drop skating, I don't think I do as well as school.
Why's that?
It just taught me concentration, and that's my, you know, you get so tense and so lopsided in your mind. And
when
you just study, sit there in front of in a chair. I started 10 years ago, I guess. Wait, 11? Okay, in my skating, it seems I have a gift for it. I don't know, I feel sort of funny about, because now we get paid and all that.
Clandestine observation. We see a roving band of skateboard cultists
practicing obscure urban rituals amidst the cultural detritus of an abandoned manufacturing facility. How is it that these cultists can derive pleasure from the seemingly insignificant, the debris of modern society? What is the strange, profound attraction that this rectangular piece of concrete holds for them? Do we now observe the rites of passage of a newly emerging civilization?
America's civic engineers, confronted by a pristine natural environment, have designed their cities, their centers of commerce, for that most efficient of all applications, non-usage. These young urbanites have discovered uncharted activities within the sterile surroundings of the environment's original design. Has not this trend continued into the residential neighborhood? Why, even into the local schoolyard, where even the simplest activity has been pre-planned, tested, surveyed, and accordingly constructed for singular purposes. Preordained usage. Yet our cultists have created their own usage, their own interpretation.
Well, my son Casey Elliott really likes to skate, so living out in the country here, I thought we'd just put this ramp in, give him a chance to learn how to skate. I think that it's a great sport. I think a lot of parents should really, even maybe before they move and buy a house, check with the neighbors next door, see how big their backyard is, they could put a mini ramp in. I feel kind of that's what being parents is doing things for your kids like this. Sport. It has coordination. It's a great sport.
You guys realize this is a high ollie zone? Did you know that?
No, sir.
Do you know what you were doing out there? It was weak. Weak! Weak! I'm gonna have to write you a citation.
Another code 97A. Weak ollies.
Da. Slavuje ollies. Javitsleje miroi problemoi. Da.
What motivated me more than anything else to go in this direction with my skating is my love for gliding. Gliding and turning, I think, are the heart and soul of skateboarding. You could take almost everything else away, aerials, board flips, ollies, even ramps, and you'd still have something that you could call skateboarding. But if you took away gliding and turning, you take away the very essence of the sport. So it was the magic of effortless gliding that originally drew me to skateboarding and that made me fall in love with it.
It's lighter than air, ultra resilient. Lighter than a two-ton rat. Ow! We'll be right back.
champion. Counsel? Advance. Never forget.
Oh, so you want to go skating?
Never function.
I've been skating for about, say, 11 years. When I first started skating, we built this little tiny quarter pipe. Me and my friends down the block built it. And we used to skate that every day.
Until the parks opened up, and that was called, it was Winchester Skate Park that opened up.
I started skating about, I'm not sure, about 1975.
I like making skateboard ramps the size or the style of a skate park.
I'm around about the time we did the Animal Chin video, or a little bit before. We're figuring that ramps had to be changed, you know, they had to be wider and they had to have more obstacle type things.
Okay, go.
I built a skateboard park for Kevin Harris and keep on going.
Figured that we should probably try to do something that is more like a skate park, because that's where the kids learned, I thought, because they skated small things and they worked their way up. And so I tried it at Kevin Harris' skate park. We built small ramps and they lead all the way up to vertical.
Seems like a lot of kids these days are going to get better faster.
There.
Just because they'll learn stuff on the street and then they'll learn stuff on the mini ramp.
my drive is just progression. It's just to be able to keep going on and doing new things. Scary. Traveling, fun times, occasional spontaneity. I'm just an electronics person. Technical stuff.
Skaters right now remind me a lot of aviators used to be. You knew you were in an elite group.
Learn how to fakie, learn how to kick turn both ways, front side and backside, and then learn how to hit the lip, rock and rolls, grinds. I like to go fast.
We'll be right back.
you're gonna hum like you never thought you could hum before.
Yeah, bare those rat bones, you fly. You're gonna fly like a bird with one wing. Where you land, honey? Where you land, sugar? You ain't never been there before. Mm-mm. You do a fast play. We'd be the sons of Sabbath. You're gonna hear those curbs. They're gonna speak to you, child. You listen. They're gonna speak to you. Cause they are curbs. They're your curbs too, baby. I got four wheels under my feet. Now I'm gonna move all over your head. It's just